What to do? No, don't. I know many evenings I come out here with a sort of devil-may-care joie de vivre. Yeah, I speak French. Get over it, bitch. So, you know, but what you've been seeing is a facade. These are the tears of a clown. Crocodile tears, if you will, because I'm really hurting inside. I don't know if you know that some time ago I told you that I had a girl that I loved. Her name was Nadine, and she was from England. But, and then I told you I ate her.
It's
good to see you, baby. You're still a little high, right? So now, I told the folks at home, baby, that I ate you.
Yes. Lovely, yes.
Yeah. Yeah, but ain't she cute, everybody? So, here's the thing. I told him that because I was embarrassed to tell him the truth, baby.
Please tell them.
Oh, all right then. I was kind of hoping you'd tell them, baby. But...
All right.
Well,
the truth is, you didn't eat me at all.
That's true. That is true. I did not.
You only chewed on me a little bit.
Hey, what can I say? You know, I'm part European. Now, listen. The thing was that Nadine left me and went to Europe, and I was embarrassed to tell you because I wanted you to think I was cool and that no girl could ever break my heart, but Nadine broke my heart, and I didn't want to say that. And now that she's come back to me, everything's cool.
Well...
Isn't that right, baby?
Yes, it's lovely, very nice.
Yeah. Are you sure you're from England, baby? You just sound like one of them infomercial dudes to me.
No, I don't care about Hoovers and their suction, so no.
All right, well, say hi to the folks. I just wanted to let you know. We'll be right back with Nadine. Give me a kiss, baby.
Hello.
Or else it may appear to the viewer at home that you have been bribed in some way. Perhaps someone may go on the internet and say, I'm bribing people to come to the show. Are you kidding me? It costs more than 20 bucks to get people in this dump. Hey, everybody, I've decided to talk like this today. What do you think? It's, what is it again? What kind of a day is it? It's, oh, yes. It's a great day for America. That's the kind of a day, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. actually, it's a great day for me. I had the best weekend I've had in any... a good weekend. I had a good weekend, is what I... I went to two major American cities this weekend. Two fantastic, teeming metropolises. I was in Thackerville, Oklahoma, and then... Do not. Thackerville, Oklahoma, and then Austin, Texas, which is Texas for liberals. I know. It's funny though, there's like yeehaw and a Prius. It's very interesting. Anyway. But I was in Thackerville first. Now, Thackerville, if you don't know Thackerville, that's who amongst us? But Thackerville, Oklahoma, it's on the border of Texas and Oklahoma. And I like Oklahoma. It's very flat. It's like Holland with guns. And it's a. Anyway, so I'm going to say, now I've been to Thackerville before because they have a casino there, an Indian casino. It's actually quite sad because before the white man came, it was all casinos. I think I got in a little bit of trouble there, but we'll keep going. It'll be all right. Anyway, so I go to Thackerville, Oklahoma, and they've got this big casino. This is giant. It's an enormous casino, this thing. And the last time I was there, it really, there was nothing really there. It was like, you know, a couple of trailers and a Piggly Wiggly. So I was thinking it'd be the same. And I turned up, and if you're going to Thackerville by plane, you land at Thackerville Airport. They don't. Anyway, I landed at Gainesville in Texas, and then I got driven to this big giant casino by a guy who works there called Freddie, I think his name was. And Freddie was local, and he was driving me up, and I turned up at the casino. I'd never seen this. It's like Europe. It has like Big Ben and the Roman Colosseum, all that. Like, it's like this, Europe has been condensed into this small Oklahoma town. And I was driving up to it, and I said to the driver, Freddie, I said, what on earth is that, Freddie? He said, that's a facade. And I was like, you mean like my confidence? He said, no, like your sexuality. They're not stupid out there, they're fast. Anyway, so I was doing, and so before the show, I was doing this show in this giant, they have this giant, I think it's about the size of Spain, this theater. But before I did the stand-up show, I went to they have their Toby Keith. You know Toby Keith, right? Well, Toby Keith has a, don't clap. He's not here, he won't care. Maybe somewhere Toby's like. But I don't think so. Anyway. So they have, Toby Keith has this chain of restaurants called I Love This Bar and Grill, and they don't advertise on CBS. Well, they do now. So I go to this restaurant, Toby Keith's Bar and Grill, and it's in Oklahoma, and Toby's from Oklahoma. And he wasn't there, though, which was a bit sad. But they serve all this meat, and when you buy meat in Oklahoma, it's really a lot of meat. Really a lot. Like, I ordered ribs, and they gave me ribs like it was a rib cage. You climb inside and eat your way out. It's fantastic. Anyway, so I get the ribs, and in Toby's restaurant, and they play Toby's old videos over and over again, so in case you're not familiar with Toby's work, you'll get to see it. And Toby, I don't know if anybody knows this, he used to have a mullet, you know, business in front, party in the back. I've never given him a hard time about it on this show. And the next time he's here, I won't either, because he's like 6'5" and 300 pounds, but I'll do it now while he doesn't notice. Except somewhere he's going like this. Anyway, so I did the show in Thackerville, and it was really nice, and the people were really lovely, and then I had to go away from the facade, and I went to Austin, Texas, which was the second hotel, right, of the weekend. Now, both hotels I was in this weekend, no porn. What the hell? What's happening in this country? No porn? Like, what the hell kind of classy joint is this? No porn in Thackerville, no porn in Austin. I didn't know what to do with myself. Well, no, wait. Of course, I did know what to do. Just had to do it unassisted. Anyway, so, and then I was in Austin, Texas, which I told you about. It was fantastic, except I had eaten, like, my way out of the ribcage in Taco Bell. And then when I got to Austin, but that was like a day later, I started to get hungry again. And then I was looking around Austin, and all they've got is hot sauce and beer. So I didn't have anything to eat. And then, anyway, it was fantastic, and the people were really nice. And I can't I thank them enough. Texans and Oklahomans, try and put aside your differences. If you could see how beautiful you were, you wouldn't be so angry at each other. And then, so I get back today. Now, here's the big news. Oh, it's the commercial break time. I've got really big news. It's almost as if I was using some kind of TV trick to make you stay through the commercial break. I would never do that. Actually, I might. But I do have some news. But it has to wait, because now it's the vacuum cleaner guy. Does your vacuum cleaner have the proper amount of suction? Take a break, we'll be right back, everybody.
And now, Craig's Spanish word of the day. Today's word is jefe. Jefe.
I am the Jeffy around here. That's right, I'm king of the crap heap. All right, here's the big news. Are you ready? All right. Those of you who watch this show often, I'm sorry you can't afford cable. You will know that I have been, for some time, I've been on the Twitter. And I've been calling people that follow me on the Twitter, they get to call themselves part of my robot skeleton army. And the reason I call them that is because it sounds awesome. No. It just does. And we all pretend we live in a hollowed out volcano. Which, I admit, sounds awesome. And then I thought that got me to think, because I love robot skeletons. It started because I loved the movie Ghost Rider, you know, where the skeleton rides a motorcycle. And I thought, that is so awesome. I mean, a skeleton with his head on fire, that's awesome. So then I thought, well, wouldn't it be great if there was such a thing as a robot skeleton? And then it could be a robot skeleton army, and they could live in a hollowed out volcano. And then I thought, wouldn't it be great if this was like a proper late night show where where, you know, there was a band and a sidekick and a wide array of people coming and going who presented it from time to time. Wouldn't it be great if I had a sidekick who was a robot and a skeleton? Yes, agree. Now, the best robot builder in television, you know, you can't really get to him. You know, like in Jaws, when they say, they go to the guy that's the shark hunter, and he says, you're gonna need a bigger boat, that guy. Well, there's a guy like that in television who makes robots. You can't really approach him. His name's Grant Imahara. He works on the Mythbusters show, and he makes robots. But you can't go to, he actually lives in a hollowed out volcano. But I got him on the Twitter, and I said, and on the Twitter he said, if I can get him 100,000 followers on the Twitter, he will make a robot skeleton sidekick for this show. Which I know, I nearly poop my pants. I know. So he's got like, I mean, this shouldn't be hard. He's already got like 95,000 or something. So I need every viewer of this show to contact 5 more people and get on the Twitter and follow Grant Imahara. And then he'll have to build a robot skeleton. Now here's the great part. It'll be free. And because I know you probably think we have a lot of money to make this show.
Do you know how many cars most late night TV guys have? About 50. You know how many cars I've got? One for each house. Anyway, with the late night wars, you know, hotting up with, you know, Jay's back and now, who gives
Tootsie Fruits?
Well, what I'm saying is, in order for this show to survive and be competitive, we need a robot skeleton here. And frankly, this isn't going to cut it. And although... So... That's pretty much my big news. Yeah, it's not that big, really. It's big to me, though. And that's... Well, I feel foolish now. Are you looking at me like that? That's the way it is. Big to me, probably not a big deal to you, what can I tell you? But it is to me and my robot skeleton army. We'll take a break. We'll be right back with the emails and the Twitters and stuff. We're celebrating stuff, and it's email Twitter time. Do the jingle.
Twitter, tweeting, ephemeral, fleeting, Flugan web, face code, twits zone, ask mode, jigs the tweets,
und also emails.
This is a tweet from Aaron in Phoenix, Arizona. He says, Greg, have you ever been in a hot air balloon? People say it's great, but I think I'm too scared. Am I lame? Yes. No, not so much. I don't know. I've never been up in a hot air balloon. I've been in helicopters, I've been in an airplane, and that's it. Never really a hot air balloon, helicopters and airplanes. You kind of you start, you go somewhere, and you get there. A hot air balloon, you get up, you go down, and you might go somewhere if there's a breeze. I'm just saying. Ah, this is from Gerald in Shirley in New York. You'll wake up the censor. Gerald says... Dear Craig, have you ever considered getting blonde highlights? Not only have I considered it, but also in my head. No. I wanted to dye my hair peroxide blonde for a while on this show. And I'll tell you why. Because I have a very low boredom threshold. It's true. And I thought if I dye my hair peroxide blonde, that will anger some people. And then I'll get angry back and we'll have a great laugh. But the CBS won't let me dye my hair blonde. Perhaps if enough people went on Twitter and said, Craig, we want your hair to be blonde for a little while. Baby steps, baby steps. Let's just get the robot skeleton first before we try anything hard. Try anything hard. This is from Donna in Texas. Wonder if she's in Austin. Donna says, I was pulled over by the police for the fourth time. So excited, I asked if I could have my picture taken with him. Was that bad? Oh, you'll get your picture taken, all right, Donna. Cut down, cut down. Yeah.
Let's do an email. That's how the old folks send in the stuff.
I don't know how to use Twitter. I liked it back in the old days when it was email. You know, this used to be all casinos all over here.
This is from Susan in New York City. Susan's one of those names, isn't it? You don't know if it's a boy or a girl. Dear Craig, says Susan, Dracula is listed in the Amazon Kindle store as non-fiction. Is that book really true? Yes. It's based on some true stories about an old middle-aged count. It's about, you know, what's his name? Vlad the Impaler. He used to turn into a bat. You know, the one thing about Dracula wearing a cape that I don't quite buy is usually people only wear a cape if they're a magician or very fat. Sometimes, I understand that I struggle with my weight, and I always know it. If I get to cape, I've gone too far. I have to come back. When you start thinking, you know, I'm thinking a cape would go. I think a cape would go good with this white cap. Then it's time. Well, I hope that's helped everybody. We'll take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Guest tonight is a very, very beautiful actress with lovely hair. She does have lovely hair. I mean, other parts of her are lovely too, but it would be wrong of me to comment on that. Here's a tip, gents. If you ever want to compliment a lady, compliment her hair or shoes. Don't go straight to the breasts. That's wrong. I learned that the hard way during the commercial break. Anyway, she's in this big new series, Parenthood, that premieres tomorrow night at 10 o'clock on NBC. Who used to be on at 10 o'clock? Oh, never mind. Take a look at this. The lovely Lauren Graham, everybody. Lauren Graham. Lovely. What lovely hair and shoes you have.
That's not what you said at the break.
And your breasts are attractive too.
Thanks.
You do look nice, and you're playing somebody's mom in this show.
Yeah.
A teenager's mom? That doesn't make any sense.
Two teenagers' mom.
Really?
Yeah. It's true.
It doesn't make any sense. So you're still at the acting then?
Yes, because you won't let me come and be your co-host.
I would love you to be my co-host.
No, you want a skeleton on a bicycle or whatever.
Look. Here, where is it? Hold on. Here, hold that a minute.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Oh, here's one left over from the old late night wars. Hold that a minute as well. All right. No, then. No, you better not.
Oh, no.
You're working for him now. All right.
Oh, yeah, that's my boss.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Thank you, sir.
All right.
And
so,
Liza. All right. Yeah.
So, look, this is the kind of thing I'm after. This is not really you.
I just don't understand it. What kind of breasts does this thing have?
Well, none yet.
Ew!
Also, I'm not... No, it's going to be a dude. It's going to be a robot skeleton. Well, I don't know. It's this robot skeleton. They're asexual. Although I have chosen a name for him.
What is his name?
You ready?
Yeah.
No, I haven't told anybody this. I've chosen a name for my robot skeleton sidekick.
Okay.
Jeff Peterson.
I think I dated him.
Do you get people... Are you on the Twitter?
No, but somebody... I think maybe several people pretending to be me are on the Twitter. So how am I doing? I don't know.
I used to get better. That's why I went on.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
But now you're obsessed with it and you're kind of gone crazy.
No, have I? I don't think so.
No. Oh. Only a little more than usual.
Yeah, no, I don't. I'm just trying to have a good time.
Oh, I know.
I just want robot skeletons and stuff.
Tell me of the fun you're having on the Twitter. Are you having a good time?
It's all right. Some people are really jerks, though.
Oh, really?
Yeah, are you not? You must do emails or
nothing. No, I don't do anything. I don't do the Facebook or anything. I'm too sensitive. I can't take it.
What about writing? Do you ever do writing?
Oh, no, that's for old people. No, really? I do that.
What about reading? You ever read anything?
This thing, you know?
Oh,
this is how I do my...
Stonemasonry. Have you ever tried stonemasonry?
No, have you? Have you ever shot a horse, though? I have.
Oh.
not shot one.
Well, you just said shot one, and then...
Shod one.
Shod,
like a, you know?
You put a shoe on a horse.
Yeah.
One of your fabulous shoes, or just a regular horse shoe?
Only after you complimented him on his breasts. Then you give him new shoes.
Don't compliment a horse on his breasts.
No.
I learned that the hard way. Yeah.
No, I was a horse person growing up, and I have shod a horse.
That's actually quite hard, shodding a horse, isn't it?
Yeah.
Shoeing a horse.
Shotting. Let's just go with shotting.
No, I think
anyway,
shooing, yeah.
Anyway, but how is the Twitter going?
No, I want to talk about the horses. Do you still ride around on horses? Like, do you go to work on a horse?
Yeah, it goes with the stonemasonry communication. I pull up to the gate. I can't even do it. How would you pull up to the gate at work on your horse? Yeah. And there's my ID.
That's all right. I remember you from yesterday. That's probably what you said.
That's good.
Do you actually have a horse then? Do you ride around?
I did as a kid. I worked in a barn and I, you know, rode every day.
Wow.
It's what I thought I was going to do with my life.
And then what happened?
I don't know. Show business. No, I don't know.
Was there a traveling circus that came through town with maybe a handsome acrobat?
I got in the school play. So I stopped riding. And I was going to be a mounted police person or a jockey, but wasn't going to work out. And I just said those were my choices because I can't type. It was
stonemason, horse person, jockey, mounted police person, or actress.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank God this kind of is working out.
You know, it's working out well. And it's Ron Howard and the...
Brian Grazer.
That's the one.
The guy with the hair. Hey,
a bit like that, actually, his hair, isn't it?
Yeah. Great, now I've insulted two of my bosses.
Yeah, that's right. We'll get to Howard before the commercial break.
Ron Howard's like the nicest person. It's crazy. I get so nervous because he's so nice and I'm so sarcastic. I'm afraid I'm going to deeply offend him with my, like, you know, hey, blah, you know, like whatever I do.
Your double pistol dance? You're gonna scare one of the most powerful men in Hollywood with your double pistol dance? Yeah, I can imagine.
And so I get like real quiet around him because I don't know how to be sarcastic. I don't know what to say.
Was that sarcastic there when you said that there?
No.
All right.
So he's so nice. He's so nice and it makes me nervous. But do you know?
Of course he's nice.
Yeah. Well, why? I mean, no, it could just be an act.
Well, it might be an act for you. Maybe he is not nice.
Why would he put it on just for me?
Well, because he's frightened of the two pistons.
It also has a sound to it. It goes...
Oh, yeah.
You know?
No, that's good.
It's scary.
Yep. I was a bit scared there.
I know.
Yeah.
But do you know, I have always wanted to be blonde, too.
Well, let's do it for a night.
Can we, though?
I don't know. I mean, apparently, if there's enough people on Twitter...
But can they Twitter on my... For you know, on my behalf to you, since I'm not on the Twitter?
I can't be answering your Twitters.
Come on.
I've got a Twitter to answer.
Why not? Show to do it. You can do it all day, and then on the show you can answer some of my Twitters just about if I'm going to be blonde or not. Come on.
All right, but only because I'm frightened of that. Yeah. We're completely out of time, which kind of bothers me a bit.
I know. Well, yeah. I just haven't seen you nearly enough.
All right. Well, do you what?
Should we? What? I mean, what are the options? You're in charge.
Well,
It says zero on the clock. It seems very ominous.
I know, and he's kind of moving backwards and forwards a bit as well.
Uh-oh. What does that mean? What do you mean? When he moves?
I mean, he's uncomfortable.
He's, like, nervous.
Well, he thinks I'm going to bump the second guest.
Oh. Oh, no.
Yeah.
Do you know that I just have to tell you that I was bumped this morning. I've been doing press this morning for a veterinarian in Alabama who was tending to a puppy. But the puppy had pneumonia.
That's not a laughing matter.
No, I know. Well, that's why. I couldn't be upset, but it was a live kind of, you know, satellite thing, and they kept saying, you know, hold on, hold on. And then the vet was taking calls about the puppy with pneumonia. And then they were like, we're out of time for you and your parenthood show.
Well, actually, my next guest.
Puppy with pneumonia,
yeah. Guest is an actor. He stars in The Big Bang Theory, which is on Monday nights on CBS. Ha ha! Take a look at this.
Oh, look, an Indiana Jones connect the dots? And an Aquaman action figure.
Looks like someone drew a penis on him.
Oh, that'll come off.
You see what you're doing? Stop that.
Please welcome Simon Helberg, everybody. Simon Helberg. Well, I'm there at this. Simon, lovely, lovely to see you. May I say what lovely hair and shoes you have?
Thank you. Are you forgetting something, though?
I'm sorry. I meant to compliment you on your breasts, also.
Thank you.
Hey, your shoes actually are fantastic.
They're pretty nice, right?
Wow. They're kind of like, oh, my eyes.
And then the subtlety of the socks, you know, really.
No, I like it. You're quite a snappy dresser. I always assumed that you'd be like your character, but you're nothing like that. You're...
No.
No, yeah.
Thank God. It's very easy to be cooler than him, though.
Yeah. Well, they don't do... There's not a lot of cool goes on in the characters in that show.
No.
But it's a very good show.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thank you. Yeah.
Yeah, no, very, very good. No, it is.
You're upsetting.
Yeah, 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 all right. Let's save it a bit, you know.
Let's
not overdo it. You'll get your 20 bucks.
You're playing back the amount of applause they gave you for your show in the beginning.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
It.
I mean, like, I work here all night. I get the same amount as you. You just turn up, Johnny come lately, you get a round of applause. Doesn't seem fair to me.
I have a big family. You know?
Yeah. So, what's the haps then? What's going on? What's going on with your... how'd you get your hair to do that?
Well... It was a solo project. I was at work and I showered. This is like an hour ago.
Wow. Yeah. So your hair's still wet?
It is the appearance of being, because I have a spray that makes it look wet. So I don't even really have to shower.
Wow.
I can trick people by just spray it all over
your body and you're done.
Be like, you know.
Do you do a lot of water sport activity?
No, I don't. I don't do water sports. I would swim at Stephen S. Y.'s Jewish camp.
Yes.
Really aggressive swimming team.
Now, what makes an aggressive swimming team as opposed to just the guys who like to swim?
Little Jews. Really fierce, fast, cunning. I don't delve into water.
Okay, that's all
right.
I
mean, I shower, but mostly the spray.
Yeah, you just use your spray on it.
Yeah.
When did you become obsessed with your hair?
Whoa.
Oh, I'm sorry. You know what? It's me that's obsessed with your hair.
This is.
You know what? It's all the Twitter talk. Are you on the Twitter?
You put the before everything.
I do. That's, and you know,
like,
why?
Because
I'm very old.
That's like a grandpa.
Yeah.
Have
you guys seen the...
Right.
And then you just... Whatever,
right. The Spider-Man.
Yeah, the Spider-Man.
Right.
Or the... have you seen the Iron Man?
Right. There
He's
you go.
Not really iron.
Yes.
Like that.
Yes, that kind of thing. I'm on the Facebook.
Right.
But apparently, you know, I get a lot of requests because it's just me. I don't really want to... I'm curious to get in touch with people from my past, so that's my real name.
Are you big into computers? Everybody's into computers now. Nobody's not into computers.
I mean...
Except Lauren Graham.
Yeah. Right. Yeah, no, I prefer smoke signals. I think there's still some hope there. I try to print things, and it never works. And
well,
so
printers don't work. That's
okay,
the only thing.
So that's not a computer.
No. Printers do not work.
Okay.
All printers do, because everybody you talk to, whenever I've tried to print anything, major problem, they don't work.
No,
they don't.
It's always, you know, when you want, because you're printing because you're rewarded, you've done something.
Yeah, you're
with
finished
your life.
And you'd like to print it out and give it to the officer.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah. Wow. What? Yeah, that's an interesting. We print what we have to, I guess.
No. What do you do then for your spare time and leisure activity? Do you enjoy hang gliding or any kind of airborne?
You really think I'm athletic, don't you?
I don't know. Just having a go at it. Just try it.
You know, I was more athletic as a child. I was into karate.
Karate,
and,
you say?
Yeah.
Oh, are you very?
There's
advanced?
A laugh, which is this is why I quit. Cause
no. Could you perform some kind of hashigishi right now?
No, I'm mentally. I took a lot of mental.
Mental karate.
Mental karate. I mean, I really took physical karate, but what I've kept is mental karate.
So meaning, more sort of conversational karate is what you're saying.
Yeah, I mean, we're sparring. And I became a black belt when I was 10, which is so weird.
Wow.
Yeah, I know. But it sucks because I was 10, and so, you know, in case you haven't noticed, I'm a slight man in height. Height. You dirty man.
No, I didn't go there. You went there. I didn't go there. I was thinking.
That's why you're talking about my feet so much. You're trying to.
No, you know why? Because, no, I was thinking about, whoa, karate at 10 years old, a black belt? That's amazing, I was thinking.
It was. It was amazing, except that I was like 4 feet tall and everyone had to call me Mr. Helberg. And it was like I had no sense of irony, so I would show up. And these like little Russian kids who were white belts would, you know, come up and be like, hey, Simon. And I'd be like, whoa, you know, it's Mr. Helberg. And they would be like, okay, Simon. And then I'd have to say, all right, I'm going to tell the master on you, you know.
Ah.
Because that's what you do when
that's
you're.
That's what wins the other kids over.
When you're a four foot black belt, that's your secret weapon, telling the master on the kids. So, yeah, and then I would try to punish them, and they would laugh, and I think everyone would laugh as soon as I turn around, Mr. Helberg.
But you've spun that into gold now.
Yeah.
You're in the big comedy show, you've got money.
Yeah.
You got enough for spray?
Enough, yeah. Never enough for spray.
Yeah. We're completely out of time, Simon.
Thank you.
But I wonder if I could ask you a favor.
Uh-oh.
Would you like to come back at some point?
Yeah, what are you doing later? I mean.
wait. No, I meant kind of on a date.
Oh, no cameras.
No, but please come back.
I would love to come back.
All right, well then we'll do that then.
Thank you.
Do you wanna end up with an awkward pause? We sometimes do them.
Yeah.
All right. Just relax into it.
Imagine how much better this show would have been if I was a robot. Good night, everybody.